Talk about us, Dougie.
Huh?
Tell me where you're going to take us when this is all over.
I've already told you.
Tell me again, Doug.
Huh?
Please, I'd like to hear it.
Carol?
What'd you do that for?
What take the money. Get the hell out of here, Mel. Well, you've got the chance. Dump her in the pool.
Yeah, but what did you... Carol! Carol! Come back here.
Hey, man.
Come on.
What's going on?
Did you hear that noise? It sounded like a gun to me.
Go to the office and tell my wife to ring the police.
It's all right, love. I only shoot one a night. I wouldn't have done it if I didn't have to. He wasn't a bad bloke. He was just a bit screwed up, you know? I had to do it, though.
Let's go to the office, eh?
No. I'll wait here for the police. I owe him that, please. I had to do it.
I can think of 100 things I'd rather be doing than working a night shift.
Oh, I don't know. It's not that bad. The tranquility of a calm night broken only by the gentle snoring of the inmates. And plenty of time to catch up on your reading. And no senior officers to catch you dozing on the job.
Present company accepted, I hope.
Of course. Coffee?
Yes, thanks. White with one. And you better make it strong or I don't think I'll see daybreak.
Meg? What do you think of all this hoo-ha about Smith's article being published in the Dispatch?
Well, it's understandable, I suppose. No one likes being criticised, especially the department.
Yeah, but surely if the criticism is justified, they shouldn't act the way they are. The prisoners have as much right to their opinion as anyone else. Well, even the Nagel report said they should have as much free access to the media as people on the outside.
A Nagel report? Is that what you read on your night shifts?
Why not? I like a good horror story. No, I was swatting up for it for this job.
You know how these stories, thanks, have a habit of getting blown up out of all proportion. I mean, you know what the scandal rags are like. They latch onto a story and then exaggerate it.
Oh, sure, but you can hardly call the Dispatch a scandal rag. It's a responsible journal.
Maybe. How would you feel if they ran a story on how you bashed the prison inmates?
Well, I'd sue them. There's no truth in it. But there is truth in the reports of the department's policy. They can't deny it. Look at the way they're treating that new one in isolation.
Well, that's different. It's a police request to keep her isolated. It's for her own good.
I'm sure she's very pleased to hear it, but that doesn't alter the fact that she's being punished out of all proportion to a crime.
You're becoming quite a little crusader, aren't you?
where you get out, love.
No, please don't kill me.
I'm not gonna kill you. Look, here, take this. You might need it. Now get out, I've got to get going.
Where are we? Which way do I go?
Taylor.
Seems strange not having to nag the kids off to school.
Yeah. Robert will be all right now. Arlene says he always behaves himself over there. Pity he doesn't do the same thing at home, eh?
Yeah.
I'll get it.
No, I'll go. Any news?
Yes, she's sick.
Oh, thank God. Come in. She's all right. She's all right. Well, where is she?
Quite a way out, I'm afraid. They were heading for Adelaide. Spent the night at a motel. Apparently there was an argument and one of them was shot. The other took off with Jenny, dumped her in the middle of nowhere. She managed to make it to a service station and woke the owner.
But she's all right.
A bit shook up, of course, but apparently quite well. Luckily it was a calm night. Otherwise she'd be suffering from exposure. She's in the Caniva Hospital for observation.
Where are the kidnappers?
Oh, the woman gave herself up after she'd shot her husband. The other one is still on the run. We've got the registration number of his car, so it won't be too long before he's picked up.
Well, when can we see her?
I'm just about to go and pick her up now.
Well, we'd like to go with you, if that'd be all right.
I can't see why not.
Oh, thanks.
I'll wait in the car.
Thanks. Oh. Ringwork.
Do you reckon Doreen will be in the pan for long?
Shouldn't think so, love.
It's a pity she couldn't find out who was in there.
Yeah. Those rotten screws that shanghaied the mystery lady before Dore got slung into isolation. She's probably sunbathing down Barnhurst by now.
Oh, I doubt that.
Well, she must be somewhere and she isn't here.
Well, they were going to put her in Barnhurst. Why didn't they do it straight away? I mean, what's all the secrecy about if she's only going to be here for a couple of days?
Well, do you think she's still here?
Yeah, that's my bet.
Well, if she's still in Wentworth, where is she?
Oh, they probably transferred her to isolation.
Yeah, they're shifting her around so we can't see her.
Well, where's isolation?
Oh, it's an F block. There's hardly anyone ever in there unless we're full to the gills.
Do you mean she's got the whole place to herself?
Yeah. The only thing I can't understand, though, is why they didn't put her in there in the first place.
Well, I'll tell you why. Because they would have had to have brought her through H block, and then we could have had a good cup and cook it up.
Yeah, that's probably true.
Yeah. Well, the screws are just making it easy for us, aren't they? I'll find out who the mystery lady is.
Well, I wouldn't bet on it. If they want to be so secretive about it, they would have blocked off isolation pretty well.
We'll see. There are other ways through. You just leave it to your old Lizzie. Now, if the screws come creeping around, you just cover for me, will you, love?
Yeah. You reckon she'll get through?
Well, if anyone can do it, Lizzie can.
I'm afraid so, Mrs. Powell. It's an ugly thing, I know, but...
She was all right. You didn't say anything
I didn't know anything until we got
here. Didn't know? You're on the case. What the hell were you doing? You should have known.
It's all right, Cole.
It is not all right. Our daughter...
Don't, Cole.
Jenny has been raped. Our little
girl... Shut up.
Don't, love. It's not going to help things at all. Jenny's all that matters now. How is she, Doctor? I mean, she's not...
She's taking it very well. You have a brave daughter, Mr. Powell. Of course, a thing like this can have very serious repercussions in the long term. She'll need all your love and understanding.
Well, I think we can give her that. Don't you, love?
This woman, the one who called me, have you got her?
Carol Lewis? Yes, we've got her.
And the man she killed, was he the one?
Yes. Carol Lewis shot him. They were married. Apparently she protected your daughter throughout the whole thing.
Killed, she did.
Yes.
Oh, God.
That's the last time we'll send you out on the messages, young girl.
Take her to the car. Come on. I'll be with you in a minute. Is Carol Lewis? Where is she?
She'll be transferred to the city watch house later on today. But you won't be able to see her.
No. I can wait until she comes to me.
Bagger it.
I'm sorry, but I know Mrs. Davidson won't allow you to send this.
Oh, come on, it's a letter to a mate.
Helen's mad. I bloody knew it.
I know that. But the reason you're here is so that no one knows where you are. It's for your own protection.
Who says so? Bloody cops?
Yes, it's a police request.
Bloody typical. Oh, come on, Mrs. Morris. You know me, you know the others. Nobody's going to bash me up on a dark night.
Helen, we had a woman in here a few months ago who was involved with organized crime. Now, despite all our security, someone still managed to get to her. Mrs. Davidson doesn't want a repeat performance.
But I'm not mixed up with the mob. Sure, I know a few heads, but I keep out of their way and they keep out of mine.
Yes, well, that's exactly what Kathy Hall said.
This is crazy.
I'm sorry, but there are instructions. You're hearing these days. Maybe things will change after that.
What are you up to?
Oh!
We're not being nosy, Mr. Faulkner. Well, only a little bit, but that's human nature. If you was to tell us who's in there, it'd make us so happy.
I think you've heard far too much already, Lizzie.
Well, I didn't hear anything, honest. God knows I tried, I had enough. But I didn't even hear you creeping up on me.
Look, where's the laundry basket?
I left it back there. I mean, what's the harm in telling us? That's what I want to know. If you lot want to behave like James Bond, it's not going to bother us.
Drop it, Lizzie.
It's in here.
Well, get it then.
Hey, couldn't you just give us a clue? I won't tell anyone that you told me.
Back to the laundry, Lizzie.
You're gonna lock.
Welcome back to the Jason Keats Show, and I'm talking today to Mr. Harry Stanfield, who's hoping to make a big
impact. Hey, that's that guy that was on the telly.
Mr. Stanfield. There have been a lot of allegations lately that some of your business dealings have been, well, unorthodox, to say the least. What's your reaction to this?
Look, anyone who's had the success that I've enjoyed over the years and is in the public eye can expect this type of thing from people like that.
Who is this guy?
Oh, he's some big businessman trying to get into politics. He's painting himself as whiter than white, and the press are making him out to be some sort of Al Capone. He
probably is.
Why do you say that? Just because it's in the paper? You can't believe everything you read, you know. A reporter can take any story he likes and just twist it around to suit himself.
Sound like you've been through it.
Yeah, well, I have. I made a tape once for a TV station. I took out everything I was trying to say and left in all the stuff that made me look as though I was stirring.
They're not all that bad. I mean, look at Bee's article. I could be getting out early because of that.
You're not out yet, are you? I mean, with reporters being one thing and newspaper men being what they are and politicians being what they are, I mean, how the hell do we know what to believe?
Hey! I told you I'd find out, didn't I?
Did you get through to isolation?
Well, not exactly, but close enough to use my ears.
Well, do you know who it is?
Like I said, Helen Smart.
Helen? Well, why all the hush-hush?
I heard Mrs. M say that she put her there for her own protection. You know, like Kathy Hall?
Helen? That's crazy.
Yeah, that's what Helen said, but she's there all right.
Hey, where are you off to?
I'm just going to put my jeans on, Mum, and go around to Paul's place. He'll be home from school now, and I want to tell him about Jenny.
No, I don't want you to go out.
Oh, Mum!
It's all over now, love. You can't keep him locked up forever. Righto, mate, off you go. But hey, listen, you'll be back in an hour, all right?
Beauty,
and don't stop for anyone you don't know.
You'll be all right, love.
Hey, how about a cuppa? Jen, I know what happened. God, I realize what you must have gone through, and well, you mightn't want to talk about it, but I'm here if you do need someone.
I was so frightened, Mum. I thought he was gonna kill me. I wasn't came to do anything.
Hey, of course you weren't, and it's best you didn't. He was a madman. You wouldn't have stood a chance.
He just
I know.
I can't tell Dad. I just can't.
It's all right, sweetheart. Not tell him. Well, everything's going to be all right now. It's over, and you're safe here with us. Just don't let it ruin the rest of your life. Don't pretend it didn't happen. It did. But now it's all over. And if you need someone to talk to, well, we're always going to be here. But don't ever, ever feel guilty about it.
Oh, Mum!
Is it that late? What the heck's going on?
Beats me, Jude. Screws haven't been this late since last time they went on strike.
Reckon they've gone out again?
I don't know, probably. They have more strikes than the town hall clock.
Now remember, keep your mouth shut till you're outside.
Stuff old man Fuhrer. Who's that? Is that you, Mrs. Barry?
No, Lizzie, it's me, Helen.
Keep quiet, Smart.
What's happening, love?
They're dragging me off to court.
Hey, how come they locked you up on your own, Howard?
Haven't a clue.
Shut up, Smart.
Try making me. I got framed on a drug bust charge, Jude. But they can't make it stick. I'll see you next time I come in for a rest, eh? Bye-bye.
Hey, Lizzie, what was all that about?
I'm bugging around now.
Bye, Mum. Bye, Dad.
Robert, you're an hour early.
Yeah, but I've got to get to school to tell the kids what happened. Bye.
See you, son.
You're going to have to speak to him. He's making this whole thing out to be some big adventure.
Well, it is to him, love. And he was just as worried about Jenny as we were. He just shows it differently. He's younger.
Yeah. Maybe. Come on, you better get a move on.
Yeah. I didn't sleep too well last night.
I noticed.
Just don't know what I'm going to say to Jen.
Darling, don't say anything. Just let her know how much you care.
I suppose so. I just feel so bloody helpless.
And don't let her see that either. Hey, come on, we can't have this breaking us all up.
Of course not. It'll work itself out.
Just as well that girl killed that bastard. I'd have done it myself.
You sound as if you're grateful to her.
I suppose that's one way of looking at it.
If she was such a saint, why didn't she kill him before he attacked Jenny?
Thank God this is the last I'll be seeing at this place for a while.
You seem pretty confident.
What do you reckon? They can't make this charge stick. Magistrate will throw it out of court.
Well, let's hope so, for all our sakes.
You can bet on it. I'll see you, Mrs. Morrow. Good luck.
You reckon she'll be back?
Well, from the little I've heard about the police evidence against her, I'd say definitely. Oh, no.
What's up?
Another letter from Wentworth in the Dispatch.
How did that get out? I thought Mrs. Powell had it stopped.
Doesn't seem to matter what you do in this place. The women still seem to get around it. I wish they were as clever at keeping out of trouble. Right. Well, all this lot will have to be cut. Would you like to start it, please? I'll have to report it to Mrs. Davidson.
What's the point in cutting it out? It's already been published.
Departmental policy. The women may have won a round, but they certainly won't be allowed to crow about it. Oh, Mrs. Davidson, it's Meg Morris speaking. I've just discovered another one of B. Smith's articles in the Dispatch. Censorship of mail, repression, denial of human rights. Well, it's not as emotional as the last one. Yes, yes, Mr. Faulkner's already started on it. Right. Well, as I said, they all have to be censored, and she would like to see a copy.
Seems a bit bloody petty to me.
Orders is orders.
I could hear all the shouting. I couldn't work out what was being said.
Well, you'll probably find out soon enough when she comes back. Well, she seemed pretty sure she'll be back this time.
No, I'm not so sure about that. I reckon if the police are going to go to that much trouble, they must have something on her. I reckon she'll be back. Well, 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 if isn't a Wentworth firebug.
Come on now, she's only arson around.
How are you going, Dory?
Not bad for somebody who's just spent 2 days in the pound for bugger all.
Oh, it wasn't totally wasted. We did find out who the mystery prisoner was, didn't we, Mr. Faulkner?
Want a word with you, Smith?
Ooh. Excuse our girls.
You rang, Mr. Faulkner.
Well, who was it?
Helen Smart.
How'd you find out?
Well, Lizzie decided to take a little trip down to isolation.
This is just the sort of thing which could bring the department down onto the newspaper altogether.
Now, hang on. It was your idea for the Dispatch to use my stuff in the first place.
I know that, but I didn't expect you to jeopardize the stir. Nor use innocent people to smuggle things out for you. Do you know what could have happened to Joanne if she'd been caught?
Who?
I know Joanne took it out for you. I rang my mate on the newspaper.
Well, it was her idea, and she didn't get caught.
That's not the point. I told you before I don't like censorship. Because of your article, I've had to cut up all the copies of the paper and throw them in the bin. Don't let it happen again.
So what do you want?
He just gave me a slap on the wrist for being a naughty girl. And a pat on the back because Joe got my article in the paper.
You beauty!
Yes, send him in, please. Mr. Douglas, I hope this doesn't mean the end of the women's newspaper. Meg, have you any idea how that article slipped out?
None at all.
What about prisoners released, visitors?
Well, Joanne Slater got out the other day, but she was thoroughly searched twice. And all visitors have been carefully supervised.
I wonder if there's anything in telepathy.
Perhaps they have a secret supply of carrier pigeons.
Come in.
Thank you. Mrs. Davidson, Mrs. Morris.
Mr. Douglas, do you need me?
No, thank you, Mrs. Morris.
Well, Erica, it's happened again, hasn't it?
Yes, I'm afraid it has.
I warned you. You put a pen in the hand of some of these women and they think they're... But they think they're Laurie Oakes.
Well, the minister's not cracking down, not this time. But only because this article isn't as inflammatory as the last one. Do you know he's still receiving irate phone calls about Susie Driscoll?
Oh, yes.
And it seems that the parole board will now be persuaded to give her an early release. And I honestly don't believe the girl's ready for it.
You're probably right.
Yes, well, about Helen Smart.
Her hearing is today.
Yes, I fully realize that. I've received another request from the police to keep her segregated from the others. They seem to think she'll be returned here.
But, Ted, that is ridiculous. What is the point in keeping her whereabouts a secret when she's just had a public trial?
Well, Detective Sergeant Ryan seems to think it necessary. I could see no reason to deny the request.
Well, I can. We don't have enough officers to wet nurse one woman. Smart is well known and well liked by the other women. They wouldn't hurt her.
I admire your optimism. All right, look, put her where you like. Just make sure she comes to no harm. And as far as B. Smith's journalism goes, I suggest you confiscate all writing materials from the whole prison.
You are not serious.
Oh, yes, Erica, I am very serious.
What's the upholstery?
Colleen!
Heard the good news. How's Jeannie?
She's okay, Meg. She's a bit shaken up, but no real damage.
Didn't expect you back so soon. You haven't left her alone, have
you? Oh, no, of course not. She's with Patrick's sister. I had to come in. She was raped, Meg.
Oh, no.
What can you expect with scum of that mentality? Just a psychotic, an absolute madman. What I can't understand is that bitch of a woman. She just stood back and let it happen.
She was the one who killed him, wasn't she?
Yeah, sure. About 2 days too late. Oh, she's just as bad as he was. Bastards like that, they should be drowned at birth.
Well, what do you think? The true story of Judy Bryant.
Yeah, it's good.
Well, thanks very much. That's very encouraging.
Sorry.
Well, it's all there. Hager's still put in here to be with Sharon, the Jock Stewart business. He got busted when you're on parole, the whole bit. I know I might have gone over the top a bit at the end, but hell, you shouldn't have copped a charge just because some little tart pinched a drunk's wallet.
No.
Well, what do you think?
Oh, well, it's great, you know. It's very good. I just wish you wouldn't print it, that's all.
Well, why not?
Well, it's great. It's emotional. It's great.
Okay, so come on, why can't I publish it? When I wrote that article about Susie, a few people sat up and took notice. Maybe it'd do the same for you.
Yeah, that's what I'm afraid of.
What do you mean?
Laurie.
Haven't you told her you were in here yet?
Well, I meant to, but things were going so well the way they were. You know, Wally was posting my mail to her and bringing me her mail, and oh, I didn't want to cause any more heartache.
Oh, bango, isn't that a brilliant idea?
Well, we could still print it, love. We just don't have to say I'm back inside.
But it's supposed to be a letter from Wentworth. What's the point of writing an article about someone who's living happily ever after on the outside?
I'm sorry, love.
Yeah, it's okay. Oh, I don't know what the hell I'm going to write about now.
You wanted to see me, Mrs. Davidson?
Oh, yes. Come in, please. I've just had a call from the City Watch House. Carol Lewis will be brought in tomorrow.
I see.
I'd like you to process her in when she arrives.
Of course.
Not that I think Colleen would be unable to handle it, but there's no point in making things harder for her.
Yes, I know what you mean. Has Colleen spoken to you?
No, why?
Well, I think you should know. She told me her daughter was raped.
Oh, no. I was afraid this might happen. How was she when she told you?
Well, it was just so unnerving. I can't explain it.
Well, in that case, make absolutely sure you process Lewis. Colleen is a fine officer, but I've no doubt she's a good mother, too.
Well, if you
you want to write about somebody who keeps coming back in here all the time, why don't you write about me?
I couldn't do that, Doreen. You're my mate. If I wrote the truth about you, the whole world would know you're a dill.
Oh, gee, thanks.
Why don't you write about Lizzie? She's led a colourful life. There's bound to be a story or two there.
Yeah, but not much of a crusade, is it? I reckon once the press is running hot, you should keep it that way.
Well, if it's hot stuff you want, honey, here I am.
What are you doing back here? I thought the beak was going to let you off.
Yeah, well, that, me old mate, is a long, sad story.
There I was, quietly minding my own business, when the D's come knocking on the door, acting on a tip-off. Well, what can you do? They found half a kilo of hash in my linen cupboard, or so they said.
So who set you up?
Haven't a clue.
Could have been the cops.
Well, I don't see why. I've always gotten along very well with the local constabulary. I give them a few bucks every year for their local Christmas fund, and they ring me if there's a bust on. I didn't even know the guy that booked me, Detective Sergeant Ryan. Can't imagine why he'd want to send me down. Now the mongrels landed me with 12 months.
Well, what made you think you'd get off?
A misguided faith in human nature, Judy. A client of mine with friends in high places always swore he'd get me off the hook if ever I needed it.
Yeah, trust a man to let you down, huh?
Well, mind you, we did have a bit of a blue a few months ago. I thought it was all over and forgotten, but obviously it wasn't.
Is there anyone else that's got it in for you?
Oh, I've trodden on a few toes in my time, but I can't think of anyone who'd be willing to dump a pound of hash to set me up. Now, the only thing I can think of is that someone stayed in my flat the last time I was in and they left it behind.
You're not telling me you left your flat open?
Of course. A lot of my friends have got keys. People come, people go.
And leave a load of hash for you to get busted with. Well, that's nice friends.
Listen, honey, why don't you appeal?
Oh, how? What can you do when you're caught with the stuff?
Well, you could ask to see a solicitor and find out what your chances are.
Yeah, it's worth a try.
Well, I suppose so.
Have a word with Faulty Faulkner. He'll tee it up for you.
No time like the present.
Mr. Faulkner, when can I see the governor?
What about?
I want to speak to my solicitor about an appeal.
All right, I'll see you later for you.
Vic, I think I'm going to need your help.
Sure, what for?
We've got to collect all the writing material in the place. Pens, pencils, writing pads, everything.
What on earth for?
To stop B. Smith writing a stupid article for the newspaper.
But that's ridiculous. I mean, what about the Weekly Stir and personal letters?
Well, they'll be able to write in the rec rooms in the evenings. Then we'll have to collect everything again. Come on, we'll start with Smith's.
They'll only pinch stuff from the workshops.
Then we're going to have to be extra careful, aren't we? You can check Burns' stuff. Who sent it the newspapers this morning?
Steve Faulkner, why?
I think he's got a bit of explaining to do.
I'm sorry, all I know is that I threw the clippings into the waste paper bin. All of them.
Then how do you explain this in Smith's cell?
Well, it's pretty screwed up. She must have got it out of the bin somehow.
The women don't have access to reception.
Mrs. Morris took one of the clippings out of reception to show Mrs. Davidson.
Which is still here. Now, this clipping either came from reception or somehow found its way into the prison.
I'm sorry, I just can't help. The women seem to have a magical touch when it comes to getting things in and out of the prison. Well, how did Smith get the article out of the dispatch in the first place?
I'm looking into that matter.
Yeah, perhaps they wouldn't break the rules so often if there are a few less rules to break.
Mr. Faulkner, when I gave you the job of looking after the prison newspaper, I expected you to help the women in general. Not encourage one woman to start a public crusade against the prison system. I appreciate your views about the gagging of the press, but unfortunately such niceties do not exist in penal institutions. Your job is to help the inmates and administration. If you find this duty is beyond your ideals, then I suggest you start looking for employment elsewhere.
Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
I am prepared to give you the benefit of the doubt regarding this article. But in future, would you please ensure that all clippings are destroyed?
Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
Well, here's another batch of office fodder for the public service.
What's the matter, love? You've been down all day.
Oh, it's nothing, Jude. Just me getting old.
Oh, come off it. You're not over the hill yet.
Look, at my age, in the game I'm in, you can go downhill at any point.
Yeah, well, I suppose it's not exactly the job you get long service leave for.
12 months in here. I can say goodbye to Smart's catering services. I was planning on a nice little nest egg from that.
Hey, listen to this. Hazel Kent's written a poem. I used to be a mother with two delightful kids until I started thieving and landed on the skids. But now I'm just a number, and both my kids are gone. Their lives are speeding past me, and my time just drags on.
Geez, that's real good, Bee.
Poor old Hayes. How's she ever going to get over losing her kids? Have you got everything ready for tomorrow, Bee? We can start setting it up tomorrow.
Yeah, well, except for my contribution, but I'll work on that tonight and myself. I've got plenty to work on since I've spoken to Helen. And we might be able to stir the screws up a bit and find out why they kept you in isolation so long.
All right, everyone, line up. You'll be searched one at a time.
What for?
Well, what's all this about?
From now on, all writing materials are only allowed in the rec room between 6 and 8 in the evening.
What? You're kidding.
But I've got all the stuff for the prison newspaper to work on tonight.
So do it in the rec room. I'll take it there for you.
Oh, 2 hours. Whoopee!
I was going to write a letter.
You can do that in the rec room.
I'll do something about this, Bee.
Yeah, and I think I know what.
Everyone been given the drum?
Come on, ladies. Off to the rec room. Well, come on, wake up. It's telly time.
And what's going on here?
Search me. I think rigor mortis has set in.
All right, everyone. Come on, move out. The bell's gone.
Okay, Smith, what's this all about?
I thought you'd never ask. We want to talk to the governor. We would have dropped her a note, but we couldn't find any papers or pens.
Don't be so childish. Drag them out, one by one.
Sorry, I don't think I can do it.
Well, round one to us, eh?
Yeah. Round two, seconds out of the ring.
I'm sorry if this restriction seems petty to you, but you only have yourselves to blame. You can't blatantly ignore the regulations and expect to get away with it.
Well, in that case, Mrs. Davidson, you've got a strike on your hands. If the department wants to act like a pack of kids, we can do the same. There'll be no work done in the laundry or the workshop until we get our ruddy materials back.
There is one condition I insist on, if I rescind the order. There are to be no more unauthorized articles sent to the dispatch. If you wish something sent, it is to be brought to me and sent in the usual way.
And what if you don't approve of what I write?
Then you will be given the opportunity to rewrite it, or I shall edit
so
it.
So much for freedom of the press.
Yes. Everyone shut up.
That is my final offer. Take it or leave it.
What do you reckon?
Hell no. Let's stay here.
They can't do that.
Tell them to stick it, I reckon.
I don't know.
Do we get our stuff back straight away?
Yes.
Okay. Come on, girls, let's go.
Damn it, Bee, we should have stayed in there.
Yeah, I reckon we could have screwed him for a whole lot more.
Could we? By the time we've raced around the prison looking for a stub of pencil, a bit of loo paper to write, and we've got to set up the whole newspaper. What have we got to lose? Davo usually plays fair with us. Let's give her a go. But if she does jump on everything that we write, then we're back to square one. But at least we'll have had time to stash away a few writing pads and pens in case they try and do it again.
Mrs. Davidson, when can I see you about my appeal?
I beg your pardon?
Mr. Faulkner was going to tee it up for me.
Look, I'm sorry, it slipped my mind. She asked for a visit from her solicitor.
Very well, Smart. I'll phone him and ask him to come in. Mr. Saunders, isn't it?
That's right. Thanks.
Mr. Faulkner, in future, try to remember these things. It may not be important to you, but it is to the women.
What a day. I get the distinct impression I'm not the prison's most popular officer today.
Look, I'm sorry about the press clipping, but Colleen, ask me who sent it to the mayor.
I was just a mug who cut it out.
Do you know how the women got hold of it?
No. Mrs. Davison wasn't too impressed, though. Nor Mrs. Powell.
Well, Colleen's going through a bad time at the moment. And when Carol Lewis gets here, it'll only get worse. I've had that experience myself.
You have?
Yes. My first husband, Bill, was killed in a riot here. And for some reason or other, they transferred the woman who did it back here from Barnhurst.
Hell, that must have been hard on you.
I went through all the anger and bitterness. What's the point? I can't change what's happened. Chrissy changed, though. She got pregnant, and her whole personality seemed to alter. Suddenly, she wasn't the person who killed Bill anymore. I don't resent her now, but I hate the person she was. Believe me, Colleen's got a lot to go through yet.
Okay, this is the last hand. You can count me out. I'm going to work on that article. Suppose I better give some thought to what I'm going to say to my solicitor tomorrow.
Is he any good, Helen? Claims
were made today.
Should be. I pay him enough.
Owned by Mr. Harry Stanfield, a hopeful for the government seat of Pacey, were running a call girl racket for overseas businessmen. The allegations were made by a Miss Mandy Thompson, an unemployed model from St. Kilda.
What's up?
Miss Thompson.
Unemployed model? She could have been more original.
Do you know her?
Of course I do. I could tell you a few tales about old Harry, too. He's the guy with all those influential friends I was telling you about.
Was this Mandy Tart right about the call girl business?
Of course she is. And who do you think set it all up? Smart's Catering Services, that's who.
Well, how did Harry Stanfield fit in?
He's the one that persuaded me to set the business up in the first place. I used to send him an invoice for smoked salmon and cucumber sandwiches. Good tax look, but...
Well, what was about this blue you had with him?
Oh, it was nothing, really. I'd organised this wingding for him, all the girls laid on, and he cancelled it the last minute. I'd already forked out quite a few bob booking the girls, and he wasn't going to pay me. So I started jumping up and down. I even said that I'd have a word to a journo mate of mine. Of course, I wouldn't have, but made him see sense next day the cheque arrived. Well, I didn't think he'd take it this much to heart, of course.
What do you reckon, Jude?
Well, seems fishy to me.
What? Haven't you been watching the news?
And no, they don't give you a television in solitary. And the only thing I read in the papers are the funnies.
Well, your Mr. Stanfield has been playing Mr. Squeaky Clean Nice Guy because he wants to get himself voted into Parliament.
That's right, love. For all his friends in high places, he could have set you up just to get you out of the way.
Listen, how'd your article go?
Bloody awful. By the time I cut out everything I knew Dave I would object to, there was nothing left.
Well, at least we can start setting up the rest of the stuff.
Yeah, I'll try again later.
Morning, ladies.
Hi.
Morning.
Everyone to work, except you, Smart. Your solicitor's here to see you.
Good luck, love.
Yeah. We'll be thinking of you.
Thanks.
Good morning, Miss Smart. You have an appeal in mind, I understand.
Darn right I have.
Well, we will have to have a reason to appeal. You realize that? Some fresh evidence or a valid reason to claim a mistrial, something of that nature?
Well, I told you that I was set up in the...
You did indeed. You did indeed. But such a claim stands little chance against a large volume of circumstantial evidence.
Well, I think I've got an idea of who is behind it.
Oh?
A guy called Harry Stanfield?
Well, proving it would be very difficult against a man of Mr. Stanfield's reputation.
Oh, reputation, my Aunt Fanny. That guy's been in more massage parlors than you've had hot dinners.
I'm sorry, Miss Smart. Professional ethics prevent me from handling your case. Guard?
Hey, just hang on a minute.
Take my advice, Miss Smart. Forget it. Before the police come up with even more serious charges against you.
That was quick.
Yeah. Must have been something I said.
We've been expecting you. Put your things on that bench over there. Right, stand on that white line. Your name is Carol Frances Lewis?
Yes.
You are charged with being an accessory.
I'll take over here, Mrs. Morris. I'm the Deputy Governor, Lewis. My name is Powell.
Give me roses, I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain too. When morning comes around, last night I dreamed we were together, sharing.